we are coming to the prayer in Bhagavad Gita. It is there in most of the books published in India. We start with a prayer which is generally found in Gita Press publications. But before that, I must remember my gurus and name them to you. I am sitting here because a saint by name, Swami Virajeshwara, who understood that I have been reading all the 18 chapters of Bhagavad Gita every day and blessed me and told me, "Shiva Swami, you must teach Bhagavad Gita to the people around and it's your duty." And I am sitting here because of that. As a student of BA, I had Bhagavad Gita as a text and taught by a great scholar called Dr. K.B. Ramakrishna, and I salute both these gurus. It's my duty to salute all people who have been working to spread the message of Bhagavad Gita. Say, for example, Gorakhpur Press, Chinmaya Mission, ISKCON, Ramakrishna Mission, and so on and so forth. They have been trying their level best to make Bhagavad Gita reach the heart of the people. Though their concept of ultimate reality is a little different, such as Advaita, Vishishta Advaita, and Dvaita. I must also show my respect to Shankaracharya, who wrote Bhashya to Bhagavad Gita and made it one of the prasthanas of India, and also Ramanujacharya and Madhvacharya for writing Bhashya. And later in recent years, all scholars in Sanskrit or otherwise have tried to understood Gita and given their own versions of it. So I consider it as my duty to thank every one of them before I start or go to the prayer. One or two instructions before I start. I wish the listeners to sit with a Bhagavad Gita book in their hand, because sometimes I ask them to underline certain shlokas because I consider them important. You can do it. So that's why whenever you start, listen to my Bhagavad Gita program, have a book with you. Another thing is, if you study 10 shlokas per day, you will be able to complete entire Bhagavad Gita in 70 days. That will make you a different personality altogether. What time should we study? Maybe a question from some of you. You can do it any time of the day or night. All time is very precious for Bhagavad Gita. Therefore, have a book in your hand and follow the book and follow the shlokas, and then we can go on for the next things. So with this small introduction, we go to the first prayer that is there in this book. The prayer is, Tvameva Mata cha Pita Tvameva Tvameva Bandhuscha Sakha Tvameva Tvameva Vidya Dravinam Tvameva Tvameva Sarvam Mama Deva Deva. Look at the beauty of the prayer here. we have not taken any name of any god. It is thou or you. You are my father and mother. Look at the beauty. You are my father and mother, mother and father. Tvameva bandhusya. You are all my relatives. Tvameva sakhat tvameva. You are my friend. Tvameva vidya dravinam tvameva. You are all that knowledge I have got, and also all that economic power I have got. Tvameva sarvam mama deva deva. What a beautiful prayer. Except me, all other things are looked as the highest spirit exhibiting in front of us. So that is the first prayer. We go to the next one. First one is Parthaya Pratibodhitam Bhagavatam Narayanena Swayam Vyasena Grathitam Purana Muninam Madhya Mahabharatam Advaitamrita Varshinim Bhagavatim Ashtadashadhyayinim Ambatva Manusandadami Bhagavad Gita Bhavadveshinim. So this Parthaya Pratibodhitam, this has been told to Partha by Bhagavan Narayanena Swayam, by Narayana himself, the ultimate god of the Hindu culture. Vyasena Grathitam, this has been written by Vyas, as we all know. It is inserted in the middle of Mahabharata, so he says Madhya Mahabharatam, and it has been read by great seers. Advaitamrita Varshinim, this is quite important. So this prayer says, ultimately God says, in every human being he exists. Advaitamrita Varshinim Bhagavatim Ashtadashadhyayini. So Mahatma Gandhi calls Bhagavad Gita as Gita Mat. So that is there here. Bhagavatim Ashtadashadhyayinim, having 18 chapters. Ambatvam Anusandadami. Amba, that is Goddess, I pray you, I try to understand you. Bhagavad Gita Bhavadveshinim. Bhagavad Gita Bhavadveshinim, the hater of the worldly problems. Bhavadveshinim. So that is the first prayer we have got. Let me read once again for your memory. Om Parthaya Pratibodhitam Bhagavata Narayanena Swayam Vyasena Grathitam Purana Muninam Madhye Mahabharatam Advaitamrita Varshinim Bhagavatim Ashtadashadhyayinim Ambatva Manusandadami Bhagavad Gita Bhavadveshini. Go to the second one. Namostute Vyasa Vishala Buddhe Pullara Vindayata Patranetra Yenatvaya Bharata Taila Purnaha Prajwalito Jnanamaya Pradipa. I salute Vyasa, the writer of this book, Bhagavad Gita. Vishala Buddhe, he has very wide understanding, or his views are very wide. And then he has got a lotus petal-like large ears, so that he goes eyes, and he has enlightened the lamp of wisdom full of the Mahabharata oil. Mahabharata, there is one proverb usually said, what is not there in Mahabharata is not there anywhere in the world. So Mahabharata, so we are praising Vyasa in this poem. We go to the next one. Prapanna Parijataya Totra Vaitraika Pane Jnana Mudraya Krishnaya Gita Amrita Dhuye Namaha. We salute Krishna, the holder of Jnana Mudra. So this is called Jnana Mudra. He holds Jnana Mudra, and then he grants the desire of those who take refuge in him. The milker of Gita nectar, in his hand he has got a cane while he was looking after the cows and the cows. So that is the prayer in this one, and we go to the next one. Let me read that one again. Prapanna Parijataya Totra Vaitraika Pane Jnana Mudraya Krishnaya Gita Amrita Duhi Namaha. Next one. Sarvopanishadogavo dogda gopalanandana parthovatsa sudirbhokta dugdangitamratam. Wonderful prayer this is. All Upanishads are like archives. Sarvopanishadogavo dogda gopalanandana. The milkman happens to be gopalanandana or Krishna. Parthovatsa. Usually the young calves are let near the cows so that she begins to yield the milk. So Partha is a small cow. Partha Vatsa Sudhir Bhokta. The people are who want to read Gita are people who drink the supreme nectar of Bhagavad Gita. So here I tell you one thing. In our entire culture, there are three books which are called Prasthanatrayas. Number one, Upanishads. They are 10 in number. Let me name them for your memory. Isha, Kena, Kata, Prashna, Mundaka, Mandukya, Aitreya, Taittireya, Brihadaranyaka, Shvetashvatana. So there are 10 of them. They are in very old Sanskrit. All of us may not be able to understand them. So the next one happens to be Brahma Sutras. They are in the form of formula as they are in mathematics. It's very difficult to understand them. Even different acharyas give different interpretation for that. So it is not in our reach. The only thing, the highest cultural milk that we have got happens to be Bhagavad Gita, which has been told by the highest God we think of, that is Sri Krishna himself. So this is being told here to us. Next one. Vasudeva Sutam Devam Kamsa Chanuramardhanam Devaki Paramanandam Krishnam Monde Jagatguru. Very simple, you will understand. Vasudeva Suta, son of Vasudeva, Kamsa Chanura Mardhanam. When you grew up, we know all the story that he killed Kamsa and Chanura, other demons. Devaki Paramanandam, mother happens to be Devaki, and he gave the ultimate joy to his mother. Every children gives that joy to their mothers. Krishnam Mande Jagatgurum. Look here, here is a beautiful word. We salute Krishna, the Jagatguru. We have seen every sannyasis, every swami of a small mutt calling themselves Jagatgurus. But here is a real Jagatguru in the sense, wherever in the world, whatever may be his religion, whatever may be his sect or understanding, if they go deep into the Bhagavad Gita, they get solution to all their problems. Therefore, Jagadguru is he who can teach anybody who surrenders. So Bhagavad Gita has been doing that work. So we are happy about it. Therefore, the term Jagadguru is very aptly used here. Let me repeat that stanza. Vasudeva Sutam Devam Kamsa Chanuramardhanam Devaki Paramanandam Krishnam Munde Jagadguru. Next, two stanzas I will read together. Bhishma Drona Tata, Jayadrata Jala, Gandhara Nilotpala, Shalya Grahavati Krupena Vahini Karnena Velakula, Ashwathama Vikarna Ghora Makara, Duryodhana Vartini, Sotirna Kalupandava, Kaivartaka Keshava. Sotirna Kalupandava, Rananadi Kaivartaka Keshava. Here is a beautiful explanation. It is compared to a river with Bhishma and Drona as its banks, Jayadrata as water, King Gandhara as blue lily, and Shalya as shark, Krupa as current, and Karna as breakers, with Ashwatthama and Vikarna as terrible makaras, and Duryodhana as the willful. It was indeed crossed over by the Pandavas with Krishna as the ferryman. In this term you can underline Kaivartaka Keshavaha. That is, Pandavas were made to reach the shore safely because of Krishna. And my wish, when we read Bhagavad Gita, we can also Bhagavan Krishna our ferryman, so that he can take us safely to the other shore, which is called liberation. Go to the next one. Parasharyavachasarojamamalam Gitartha Gandotkatam Nanakyanaka Kesaram Harikata Sambodhana Boditam Loke Sajjana Shatpadairara Pepiyamanam Muda Bhuyad Bharata Pankajam Kalimala Pradvamsina Shreyase. Two shlokas are there. I will read out their meaning. May the tainless lotus of Mahabharata, grown on the flowers of the words of Parashara's son, having the Gita as its strong, sweet fragrance, with many narratives as its statesman, fully opened by the discourses on Hari, and drunk joyously day after day by the learned people, and the productive of the supreme good to him who is eager to destroy the taint of Kali. So we salute Krishna who destroys the Kali, the effect of Kali. Here is a thing which I must explain. We said that we are in Kali Yuga. Kali Yuga brings a lot of problems for the human beings. Krishna can make us cross this river, that is the wonderful thing in this pair. Mukam karoti vachalam pangum langhayate girim yat krupa tamaham munde paramananda madham. Look here, here is a beautiful program, stanza underline. Mukam karoti vachalam. By reading Bhagavad Gita, a dumb becomes a very talkative man. Pangum langhayate girim. Even a lame can climb the mountain when he has got the blessing of Madhava. So beautiful it is. Let me therefore read it. Mukam karoti vachalam pangum langayate girim yat krupatamaham munde paramananda madham. Yam brahma varunendra rudra marutaha stunvanti divye istavaihi vedai sangapada kramopanishadai gayanti yam samagaha Dhyana vastita tadgatena manasa pashyanti yam yogino yasyantam navidusura suragana devaya tasmai namaha. Here is also another beautiful thing. Even the gods we have got, Brahma, Varuna, Indra, Rudra, Marut, etc., they also pray to this ultimate god, Krishna. Samaveda is used for singing, so those who study Samaveda sing Samaveda to please God Krishna, and yogis see their minds absorbed in him through the perfection in meditation. Look here, how can we see God is expressed here? Dhyana vastita tadgate namanasa pashyanti yam yogino, underline this. When do we see God? Here it is said. Dhyana vastita tadgate namanasa. In deepest meditation, if we sit in meditation, we will have the realization of God. That is being told in this stanza. Dhyana vastita tadgate namanasa pashyanti yam yogino. Yasyantam navidu. There is no end to the greatness of Krishna. So this is a beautiful shloka, and the last one is Shantakaram Bhujagashayanam Padmanabham Suresham Vishwadaram Gaganasadasham Meghavarnam Shubhangam Lakshmikantam Kamalanayanam Yogihrut Dhyanagamyam Vande Vishnum Bhavabhayaharam Sarvalokaikanatham. So we are praying again the last of the prayer. Shantakara, he is very present looking man. Bhujagashena, he sleeps on the great serpent. We know Vasuki, Bhujagashena, Padmanabham Suresham. Padmanabha, that is having Brahma on his on the lotus of his body. Suresham is Isha for the entire world. Vishwadharam is Adharam to the entire Visha. Vishwadharam, Gagana Sadarsham, Megavarnam, Shupangam, Lakshmi, Kantam, Kamalanayanam, Yogibir, Dhyanagamyam, Vande Vishnum, Bhobayaharam, Sarolokaikanatham. We will pray that Vishnu who will remove all our problems. Thank you.